Guys, Amazon just launched their 1 millionth warehouse robot. 1 million. This is shocking. There are now more robots working in Amazon factories than humans. It's official. It's happened. And this is particularly stunning to me because about 8 months ago, I posted a video highlighting that this was coming. And someone in the comments said, "I'm in the warehouse. Robots can't do my job. I'm going to be good." Bro, I don't know what to tell you, man. This is happening. This is not the future. This is the now. And if you don't wake up, you're going to be screwed. And in this video, we're going to walk through kind of what this means, what the implications are, and how you can consider preparing yourself. This is what I'm doing to prepare myself. I'm the fractional CMO for an agency. I'm a creative director for a couple companies. And I just see how AI is impacting my workplace and my job. And I'm upskilling, baby. I'm creating SaaS software at night when I'm hanging out with my wife. We'll be talking, watching Survivor, all that stuff. And I'm coding, I'm vibe coding, I'm learning to code. But guys, the secret is out. You don't actually need to be a software engineer to develop software. You can create solutions. And I'm not going to get into that in this video. I talked about that a lot. I've been talking about that a lot in previous videos, but the reality is that this is a really exciting time. In times of great turmoil is great opportunity. And this is a great time, I think, to build wealth. No matter where you are on the economic scale, there are going to be significant needs that arise during this time of AI and robotics. So why is this important? Well, over the last 4 years, Amazon has laid off over 100,000 employees. And I mean, that's a pretty big deal. I mean, they employ 1.6 million people, at least they did. And now that is down because they are bringing in more robots into their warehouses. These robots are doing packaging. They are putting things on and off, taking things on and off shelves. They're bringing them to the trucks. They're doing a lot and they're faster, they're more efficient. They don't need bathroom breaks, guys. They don't need bathroom breaks. And quite frankly, as a human, you're, okay, so we live in this data age where data is driving all the decisions, tracking, attribution in the marketing world, delivery times, churn, bounce. There's so many different data points that these companies are looking at, big corporations are looking at, small corporations, you should be looking at your data too. But there's so many data points that we're looking at, and what is inevitably going to happen is the data is going to come out that humans call out sick, humans are late, humans have a lower satisfaction rate when talking to customers, and so on and so forth, right? And there's going to be places where humans excel, there's going to be places that humans fall short. But the reality is that no human wants to be micromanaged that way. A robot doesn't care. A robot just wants to execute its job as efficiently as possible. But, you know, if you're a human, you don't want to, like, have your bathroom break tracked or your walking break tracked, or you don't want to be dinged for taking a personal call. The humans don't operate like that. You want a little bit of room to spread your legs and stretch your legs. And robots don't need that. So I think that's an important distinction. McKinsey Consulting released an interesting projection. They project that over the next couple of years, there are going to be 97 million new jobs available, but only for the workers that reskill. You must reskill. You cannot continue doing the same thing that you've always done. Colleges, universities cannot be teaching the same thing that they've always taught. Coaches and consultants cannot be teaching, this is what worked over the last 5 years. This is how I got rich. This is how I build wealth. There are some concepts that are tried and true, and we talked about that in yesterday's video. I'll put a link up here about different businesses to be thinking about. But here's the reality, guys. You cannot be reliant on what got you are to where you're at today, because we're going through one of the biggest shifts in human history. And Amazon, I think this news from Amazon that they've just surpassed their human warehouse employees with robot employees is a really good indicator that that is happening. Not in the future, but happening right now. The World Economic Forum anticipates that 54%, that's over half if you're counting at home. The World Economic Forum anticipates that over 54% of employees at large companies are going to need significant reskilling. You must reskill. You must do it. And okay, so we're gonna get to how we solve this problem in just a moment. Like, what do we reskill in? What does that actually mean? We'll get to that in just a moment. But I do want to talk a little bit more about the robotics at Amazon, why this is interesting. So A, these robots are focusing on sorting, packaging, moving items around the warehouses. We talked about that. But what this doesn't necessarily, there's another piece of this puzzle, guys, that is not really even talked about in the New York Times article and in the article that the press release that Amazon released. And that is autonomous vehicles, guys. There are over 300,000, there's differing reports, there's somewhere between 275 to 375,000 delivery drivers for Amazon, okay? But, and by the way, right now it is unclear how many autonomous vehicles will be on the road. I'm not gonna get into all the stats and data on this, but, it, you know, incomprehensibly, but if, based on what I've seen and based on my predictions, in the near future, the majority of cars will be autonomous. They'll be driving each other. It's gonna be a lot safer. The reality is that humans are not good drivers. If you go out and get in your car and you drive, most humans cannot drive for crap. And these autonomous vehicles will be much safer. And that's how they'll roll it out. And there's different issues like the trolley problem, malfunctions, you know, there's reports of cars just stopping in the middle of the road and not knowing what to do. So there's problems that will get sorted, that need to get sorted out. They will get sorted out. And I would guess by, you know, by the time my kids, my daughter's 9, by the time she's driving, she'll probably be in an autonomous vehicle. We might not even buy a vehicle. Everyone's just going to be, just, you're not going to even need to own a depreciating asset, which a car is a depreciating asset. It does not actually build value for you. You'll just use your phone or your sunglasses and you'll call in a car to pick you up. So anyway, regardless, I would anticipate there's more autonomous vehicles. So there's another 300,000 to 400,000 drivers that are out of jobs. Okay, that's just with Amazon. That's not counting UPS, FedEx, USPS, taxis, truck drivers, all those. This is, we're just specifically talking about Amazon here, okay? So that's a big deal. And you might say, well, Mark, how big of an issue is this autonomous vehicle? It's becoming more significant. A lot of Teslas have already been self-driving for a while. Waymo has 2,000 cars on the road, and Waymos are fully automated. They drive themselves. They're essentially taxis. Tesla just this last month rolled out their autonomous vehicle taxi program. It was very small. It's a very short run. It was not hugely successful, but they did it. They rolled out their trial program. So anyway, you can kind of see the writing on the wall with autonomous vehicles, with robots in warehouses. It is happening. And this, guys, is not even to mention drones that are becoming ubiquitous. And drones are becoming more and more powerful. You're seeing them overtake the military world, but they're also going to be delivering. They are already delivering smaller products. So, you know, pretty soon, it's going to sound like locusts all around the sky because there's going to be drones delivering Amazon products everywhere. So you look at a big company like Amazon and how many people they're employing now and how many of those current existing roles are going to be replaced by AI and robotics. It is profound. It is a profound number. Now, that doesn't mean that you will not have work. What it means is that you will need to upskill. You will need to upskill. And this is not going to be a call to action for you to buy my training program. This is a warning that you should heed. You need to upskill. You just need to do it. And by the way, just a quick side note, I heard a clip from Bernie Sanders the other day where he said, well, AI and automation is going to be so productive that we need to push for a 4-day work week. You know, we need to have a 4-day work week. Guys, that is the exact opposite of what we need to be doing as husbands, as men, as leaders in our community. The last thing that you should do is be asking for a 4-day work week. Right now is the time where we should be proactively spending our time to learn, because when this transition is happening now, but it could happen really fast, and you don't want to be stuck in a position where you just can't compete. You need to be upskilling, okay? So how do we upskill? I've got 5 different things to be thinking about here. So the first of which is learning AI and automation. And you might say, Mark, I don't need to learn how to code. I'm not going back to college. Guys, just look. I've been, talking about this tremendously because I am shocked at how good these softwares are. But if you just pop open a program like Replit and you start building out different softwares, if you like, maybe I'll do a training on this, but just start building out different softwares, build out minimum viable products. Think about a problem that you have in your life, whether it's my wife shops too much, or I'm always late for work, or I don't know how much coffee I'm drinking, whatever the problem is, try to think about how a software could solve that and just build it in Replit. You don't need to know how to code. You don't need to know JavaScript or JSON or CSS or HTML. You don't need to know any of that stuff, guys. You just need to know how to talk. And if you can deliver a clear, concise prompt, Replit will build the software for you. It'll take you maybe a little while, and your first one will take a little bit longer. But I've created two softwares now, one of which is quite functional, the other which is still a work in progress. I don't know how deep I'm gonna go into it, but it's not that hard to build these softwares out, okay? B, develop your human skills, creativity, emotional intelligence, leadership, responsiveness. By the way, guys, I am shocked at how many people don't do what they say they're going to do. I mean, just this past week, I've had two vendors that I've been trying to give money to who have not done what they said they were going to do. They told me they were going to do something, they didn't do it. In the time, this happens all the time. Don't be reliable, but yeah, I have to basically lay people off because they don't do what they say they're going to do. It's just, I can't function that way. But there are things that a human doesn't have a soul. A robot doesn't have a soul. A robot doesn't have emotion. A robot can't actually connect on a human level. Now, don't get me wrong, there are going to be robots doing all kinds of things to humans and for humans. But I believe that's going to leave a gap for in-person events, human connectivity. So again, you can lean into that. When a robot looks you in the eyes, I don't think it's going to feel the same as when a human looks you in the eyes, okay? We'll see. We'll see how that rolls out. As I get more data on it, we'll talk more about it. You need to get comfortable with robots. Don't be one of the guys that's walking around like, oh, the robot took my job. Be the guy that says, I love the robot. I accept the robot. I want to work with the robots. That'll make you much more employable. The last thing that an employer, contractor, a vendor, a client wants is someone that's just whining and complaining all the time. You don't want to be there. Be accepting, learn, find gaps, find overlaps in your Pareto diagram where you can see that you're working hand in hand with the robots and the AI. Embrace lifelong learning. We've talked about that already in this video at length. Now is the time to learn, and you don't need to go back to college. My advice is, you know, again, it could be as simple as watching YouTube videos and just keep you like this and keeping up with them. Make sure you've liked and subscribed so you can stay up on the latest trends. But really, it comes down to execution and popping open the softwares. You know, if you're not using ChatGPT daily, use ChatGPT daily. Keep testing it. Work on improving the memory of your ChatGPT. Work on getting better at prompts. Use it for video, for audio. Use its full multimodal capabilities. Try integrating the API, which might sound crazy to you now, but you can figure it out, I promise you. Integrate the API with other programs and other softwares. You know, learning how this automation, the AI, how all these softwares talk to each other is going to be incredibly valuable moving forward. Along the ideas of the lifelong learning, just leverage training systems that are out there. Like I mentioned, YouTube is free. MIT has a free training program. There's a bunch of universities that have free training programs that likely are going to try to upsell you and get you to buy into things. But, you know, the entire educational system needs to and is changing because you don't necessarily need a college degree now. What employers care about, what I care about, contractors care about is, what can you do for me today? So that's what I would encourage you to think about. Because again, Amazon is making moves. All these companies are making moves. The big question is, are you? Type in the comments below what you think. See ya.